was developed, and an outstandingly successful theory at that. And yet, there is large disagreement about what the theory tells us about the nature of physical reality. Why is that, you think? I mean, how can a very successful theory not tell us clearly something about the nature of reality? Why do we need interpretations of the theory?
So, this is an excellent question. Why do we need interpretation of a theory that is so complete and so successful? So the theory is basically the most successful theory, or there are two theories, two big theories that are kind of unconcilable, and this is quantum mechanics and or quantum field theory, to be more precise, and general relativity. And both these two theories are incredibly precise, up to any number of decimal places that one can dare to calculate it, it will turn out to be right on the experiment, especially. And this is even more true for quantum mechanics, simply because, maybe simply because experiments are easier. And we do experiments in quantum mechanics with great deal of precision, while measuring gravitational waves is more difficult. But in any case, the fact of the matter is that quantum mechanics is basically the most precise theory that we have about nature, and for sure about the microscopic nature. And it has never been proven to be even slightly wrong. However, in order to make the bridge between these mathematical constructs that you've built in order to explain your experimental results and the ontological or epistemological nature of reality, this is not a trivial step to do in quantum mechanics. And the reason is goes back to what I used as a definition. So basically, quantum mechanics is a general theory of probability. It's a generalized theory of probability, in a sense. So if you consider this, it means that quantum mechanics is an incredibly powerful tool, because it's a generalized theory of a very general thing that we can already think of. So probability, every experiment that we do is an instance of probability. And therefore, quantum mechanics is an incredibly powerful tool. However, the statement that quantum mechanics can provide are only, in a sense, probabilistic in nature. And this implies that in order to read through them, you have to have an interpretation, how to translate these probabilistic results that you get, these probabilistic, intrinsically probabilistic results that you get, into something which is not probabilistic, or that is an ontological concept of nature that is not probably like this. It's either it's like this or not. Usually, this is what ontology usually does. But also there, maybe not. I mean, there are some ontologies and there are some interpretation of quantum mechanics that get rid of this step entirely, and they formulate an ontological probability principle, so that nature is probabilistic intrinsically, and then the only way you can interpret it is by means of probability, and you should not think what is the deepest ontological nature of things, because there is no such thing. There is only what we can evince from our experience, and this is probabilistic in and of itself. So you have all these possibilities, and in fact, I mean, all possible interpretations have been put forward, basically. I mean, you have any type of conceivable ontological and epistemological combination that can give you an interpretation of a probabilistic reading has been put forward to be a viable interpretation of quantum mechanics. So all possible combinations, there are dozens and dozens and dozens of possible interpretations of quantum mechanics, and they differ for many, they have many differences between each other. But basically, this is why, in my opinion, this is also why philosophy is so important, because at the end of the day, scientists can only, the power that the scientists have is to make testable hypotheses and test those hypotheses. What this hypothesis tells us on the nature of reality, this has never been up to the scientists up to a certain point, because I mean, you can have a realist or an idealist interpretation of nature, and this will give you exactly the same experiments, even in classical mechanics, without going to quantum. You can think that your nature is that nature is purely realist and exists without any observer, or you can go completely on the other way and be a complete idealist that thinks that nature is only observer dependent, and we know only of ourselves, and everything else can be a dream. So you have all this Cartesian argument, and in both these two worlds that are two radically different view of the worlds, a basic physics experiment like a pendulum and measuring the frequency of the pendulum will give you exactly the same results. It's not that the pendulum is telling you what of these two natures is true. It's only what is only telling you is informing you about the relation between mechanics and gravity and a lot of mechanical relations between the components of this universe, but it's not telling you what is the ultimate nature of the universe. And you can have several different views. So this is true also for quantum mechanics. With quantum mechanics, you have an additional layer, because you have this layer of, okay, whatever a scientist can do, it's only part of the story and can inform a good philosophy and cannot define an ontology, basically. But on the other hand, in quantum mechanics, you have, as you said in your presentation, you have a series of new questions that have been arisen and that were not there before, that come into the fact that some of the components that you make up in order for the quantum mechanical description to work, they are, some of these components, they need to have some interpretation which is not trivially encoded in some classical way of thinking, in a sense. They need an additional philosophical elaboration to be understood. So this is a new, you have the old layer, it's always there and will never stop to be there, most probably. And then you have a new layer that is provided by the new information that quantum mechanics gives. So the fact that nature is intimately probabilistic, in a sense, for example, I mean, this is what I was talking about before, this fact that the probabilistic theory of nature is even more powerful than a deterministic one, it's a data point. It's something that the philosopher should take into account. And then you can also consider, okay, this is a probabilistic theory because underlying there is some deterministic mechanism that makes this work, but you have to make this step, and you have to consider that ultimately what we are building in our theory and what we are observing in our experiments are probabilities that are gained from probability amplitudes, so from this new theory of probability based on complex numbers. So it's something new. That is the novelty of quantum mechanics, I think.